Welcome friends, today I am going to tell a small romantic story, Stolen Kisses in the Mid-Air. It was 3 o'clock in the morning and was downpouring outside. Everyone was sleeping except Preetis. Preetis is an engineer by profession, but now he is preparing for civil services in New Delhi. He is wide awake because he had to catch a flight from Bhubaneswar, which was scheduled at 9:30 in the morning. He completed his daily course in Jiffy. Though he was an engineer, he had a great sense of fashion and also had a rich collection of perfumes. He was not like this earlier, but thanks to Yashika who made him this. Yashika, with his friend, a special friend, while grabbing his favorite perfume, Preetis got distracted for a moment. The smell of that perfume made him remind none other but Yashika. Then he shifted his gaze from mirror and looked out to check the intensity of rain. Rain was almost stopped. He thanked God and took auto to station. Somehow he managed to get his train and reached airport. It was raining there too, though with less intensity. After checked in, Preetis was standing at the lawns, looking outside, thinking about his coaching. He was analyzing the various type of clouds that were taught to him in the class and recollecting his geography notes. Meanwhile, a known sweet romantic fragrance wafted to his nostrils. He turned his head and discovered a beautiful pair of eyes looking at him with surprise. It was Yashika, his special friend from college. Both were happy and equally surprised. Because Yashika stopped contacting Preetis when he quit his MNC job for preparation of civil services, as she felt it is not worth of taking such high risk. Preetis never ever tried to contact her as he became busy in his preparation. Now they are like two unknowns who used to be friends. After a long awkward silence, Yashika broke the ice with a coffee in her hand for Preetis. While taking coffee from Yashika, Preetis noticed her cool filled eyes, peach color lips, a small but sharp nose, beautifully messy hair, and a smile which is worth a million. Nothing has changed except the time which belonged to them. Still, it was 45 more minutes to both. While having some chat over coffee, they discovered that they have adjacent seats. Preetis had 12E while Yashika's 12F. In these 45 minutes, Yashika spoke almost everything what she missed sharing with Preetis in last 1 year. This everything included her promotions, new responsibility, marriage of her best friend to an NRI, her father's transfer, her sister's graduation function, her adopted cat and its broken tail. She did not forget to give her valuable opinion about the current scenario, that is, India-China relation, Jalika to issue, and Trump parody. Preetis played his part maturely as a patient listener. Thanks to the announcement, they had to board the flight now. After they settled down, Yashika looked at Preetis with hopeful eyes, as if she was a kid who is eager to listen story. Now it was Preetis' turn to continue the conversation. Preetis had hardly anything interesting or worth telling in last 1 year. Neither had his job nor any of his best friend married. Another most important thing, he has cat. So he was in a real enigma, like where to start and how to start. Amidst of all this confusion, the air hostess made her angelic appearance with their breakfast in her hand, which also brought relief in Preetis, who was struggling with the topics. They completed their breakfast with complete silence. After the breakfast, Yashika turned her head towards the window and started being philosophical around the clouds which are seen outside. It was hard to guess whether the so-called philosophy about clouds or the gathered knowledge about clouds during his geography class. Preetis decided to start his topic with clouds. Though initially he started bragging about his knowledge on climatology, but when she noticed Yashika is looking him cluelessly, he embarrassed. But slowly he gained momentum. He told what he learned in last one year, how his journey was from corporate hall to classroom. But soon Yashika became bored. She again moved her face towards the window, pointed out the clouds outside and asked him without moving her gaze about his theoretical knowledge about them. Then Priti slightly bent forward and put his finger on Yashika's and described her geography in the most romantic way that ever been possible. He identified them with their name, feature and shape. It was Yashika who could sense warm yet tender touch of Priti's breath around her cheeks. The warmth of the breath made her cheeks rosy pink, as if she is blushing. She suddenly turned her head towards Priti's, and accidentally the leaves met with each other's. Yashika's soft peach leaves touched Priti's small yet adorable lips. It was momentary, but it felt like the clouds conspired to make them kiss. It was a stolen kiss in the mid of the air. After they landed, before parting away, they exchanged their phone number and address with the expectation of a real kiss rather a stolen one. Thank you.